After this, I saw another angel coming down from heaven, having great authority. And the earth was made bright with his glory. And he called out with a mighty voice, "Fallen. Fallen is Babylon the Great. She has become a dwelling place for demons. Come out of her, my people, lest you take part in her sins, lest you share in her plagues. For her sins are heaped high as heaven, and God has remembered her iniquities, since in her heart she says, 'I sit as a queen, I am no widow, and mourning I shall never see.' For this reason her plagues will come in a single day, death and mourning and famine, and she will be burned up with fire. For mighty is the Lord God who has judged her. The sea has come up on Babylon. She is covered with its tumultuous waves. Her cities have become a horror. Alas, alas, you great city, you mighty city Babylon. For in a single hour your judgment has come. Flee from the midst of Babylon. Let everyone save his life. Be not cut off in her punishment. For this is the time of the Lord's vengeance, the repayment he is rendering her." Says the Lord of hosts, "The broad wall of Babylon shall be leveled to the ground, and her high gate shall be burned with fire. The peoples labor for nothing, and the nations weary themselves only for fire."
There's no need to be afraid.
Oh my God.
There's no need to be afraid.
There's no need to be afraid.
There's no need to be afraid.
We have come to help mankind.
We have come to help mankind.
We're not conquerors.
We're not conquerors.
We're enablers.
I am the supervisor for Earth. Under our supervision, you will all flourish here. Peace, health, security for everyone.
Greetings, citizens of Earth. My people have developed technologies which allow us to throw off our physical forms and travel great distances in the blink of an eye. We are in dialogue with your leaders to help the human race survive its infancy, for we believe in you. We are helping your scientists find cures for diseases which afflict your bodies, and helping you to preserve your planet's most precious resources. Many among us wage peace, and one day, with our help, war may be a thing of the past. Our army is 1 billion strong and growing. Together, we are shaping the future of humankind.
Military forces are assembling planes, helicopters, even model aircraft. Basically, anything that is in the air that is man-made is being brought down without damage to person or property. Communications such as cell phones are being disrupted.
I'm standing on the Giancola Hill overlooking the chaos in the streets of downtown Rome, where the military continue to assemble in droves. It's frightening, and its communications do seem to be scrambling, but I would say that here in the United States, they've been reported over New York, Houston, and D.C.
At least 40 cities around the world now have these vessels hovering over them.
London. Okay, the picture is breaking up, but you can see a craft there.
This is a momentous day. We're delighted to meet you, but we need your help. We're far from home.
Et nous avons besoin d'eau et de minéraux pour survivre. Ces éléments sont facilement disponibles et abondants sur la Terre.
Em troca, nós estamos prontos a divulgar nossa tecnologia avançada com vocês. A tecnologia é Letitussad. Ele é Israel. Hayeticom. Ficol el Megalen.
After we've replenished ourselves and shared with you what we can, we will leave you, hopefully better than we found you. We look forward to getting to know our new friends.
There will be more communication with your world's leaders in the hours to come. Until then, we are of peace.
We're one united people.
In a world without fear.
This is what I always hoped it would be.
They're watching us all the time. They're controlling the way we think.
He said that they're here to help us.
And the Earth has a new destiny.
La mayor parte de los habitantes del planeta se declaran creyentes. Esto debería provocar un diálogo entre las religiones. No debemos dejar de orar por él y colaborar con quienes piensan distinto.
Confío en Buda.
Creo en Dios.
Creo en Jesucristo.
Creo en Dios, Allah.
Muchos piensan distinto, sienten distinto, buscan a Dios o encuentran a Dios de diversa manera. En esta multitud, en este abanico de religiones, hay una sola certeza que tenemos para todos. Todos somos hijos de Dios.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Creo en el amor.
Confío en vos para difundir mi petición de este mes. Que el diálogo sincero entre hombres y mujeres de diversas religiones conlleve frutos de paz y justicia.
Welcome to the golden age of man.
We're one united people.
They inspired us to rise from the ashes as one people of one world. World has seen no armed conflict. Nations have put their petty differences aside
United, we rebuilt our families, our cities, and our lives. The fusion of human and alien technology not only enabled us to defy gravity and travel with unimaginable speed, it also made our planet finally safe again.
Perhaps we need some outside universal threat. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world.
Genesis 6. The sons of God saw that the daughters of man were attractive, and they took as their wives any they chose. The Nephilim were on the earth in those days, and also afterward, when the sons of God came in to the daughters of man and they bore children to them. These were the mighty men who were of old, the men of renown. Numbers 13. So they brought to the people of Israel a bad report of the land that they had spied out, saying, "The land through which we have gone to spy it out is a land that devours its inhabitants, and all the people that we saw in it are of great height. And there we saw the Nephilim, the sons of Anak, who come from the Nephilim, and we seemed to ourselves like grasshoppers, and so we seemed to them." Another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon. His tail swept down a third of the stars of heaven and cast them to the earth. Now war rose in heaven, Michael and his angels fighting against the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought back. But he was defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. And the great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. And I heard a loud voice in heaven saying, "Now the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ have come, for the accuser of our brothers has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. And they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they loved not their lives even unto death. Therefore, rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. But woe to you, O earth and sea, for the devil has come down to you in great wrath, because he knows that his time is short." Then I saw thrones, and seated on them were those to whom the authority to judge was committed. Also I saw the souls of those who had been beheaded for the testimony of Jesus and for the word of God, and who had not worshipped the beast or its image, and had not received its mark on their foreheads or their hands. They came to life and reigned with Christ for 1,000 years.